Okay, I'd like to call this meeting to order with the Traffic and Parking Commission. It's a public meeting, and the first thing I'd like to do is approve the minutes for June 1st of 2021 meeting.
Make a motion to approve the minutes.
A second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'd like to take one item out of order, and that'd be for a public hearing to receive comment on a request for approval of a bus stop improvement at Park and Hawthorne Street.
Item number seven.
Thank you. I'll speak on it if that's okay. So the MBTA came to the commission at the last meeting, which was in June, and they requested that we give them the authority to do basically a speed bump, a race crosswalk at Hawthorne. And the reason for it is that it's a very congested area with the ELC being in front and Central Avenue, you know, it's a weird layout. And by racing the crosswalk, it will make the bus, getting on the bus easier, right? So it will improve safety of the bus area, of the riders, and it will, I think, make it safer for the parents and the children also at the ELC.
Anyone opposed?
Is anybody here from the public to speak on this item?
Okay. I'd make a motion to approve the item as illustrated.
A second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. We'll go back in order here for item number three, communication of March 8th, 2021 from resident Jillian Jenkins requesting to install a blinking red light at the corner of Parker Street and Clark Avenue.
So this item was presented to the commission earlier this year due to safety concerns that were noted by surrounding residences. After we received this request, we commissioned an engineering study of this area by TEC, the city's transportation consultant. TEC prepared a set of recommendations, including a recommendation that a blinking light may be appropriate here. So presently, we are working with DPW and Housing Community Development to implement these recommendations. So we'll share sort of schedule and logistics once we have all that underway. We are planning to do it under an upcoming pavement marking contract and transportation construction contract. But more or less, I would consider this item closed.
Moving on to item number four, would be the handicap sign application of April 30th, 2021 from Lucida Chavez of 46 Ormond Street, and I apologize. Yeah,
she was here at the last meeting, and the question was because there was already one at 46, but I spoke with Paul Nowicki from the Housing Authority, and he did inform me that prior resident that had it there, she did move. She was relocated to, I want to say, Clark Ave.
Okay.
So yes, she is now living there, and the other applicant is no longer there.
Okay.
So we can just transfer, like, it's just the sign to into her application.
That makes sense.
If everybody approves it.
Great. So there's nothing for us to do.
Well, we have to approve it, approve her application, but the prior resident is no longer there.
Gotcha.
So are you able to park in the space that's currently available?
Can you speak? Come to the microphone. Thank you.
So that's kind of been like a little problem she's been having there. That's all.
So all handicap spaces, that they are available to all members of the public that have a placard. So even if we can approve the request this evening, the space that will be instituted can still be used by other folks. So it's on a first-come, first-served basis. We don't have the ability to reserve spaces.
When someone takes her parking and she'll park in another street that has a handicap, she gets a little note from the person letting them know, like, you know, this is my spot. I went, you know, I went to get this for myself. So then she moves because they tell her to move. So that's been...
Understood. Yeah, so no person has a legal authority to that space. So the spaces don't belong to anyone in particular. They can be used by anyone with a placard. But I understand what you're saying completely.
So you can approve this application?
I make a motion to approve it.
Can I second?
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All set for number five?
Yep.
All right, on the agenda, number five, communication on May 19th, 2021, from Algeria Fentizo, I apologize, I can't pronounce your name, of the Chelsea Dental Association requesting multiple hearings on parking spaces at 109 Washington Avenue.
Do you want to sign your name and your address and then speak into the mic?
Ajali Abbas, secretary to my office. I represent Chelsea Dental Associate. Last hearing, you guys unanimously voted for 2-hour parking limit with permit, residential parking permit. That limit our access to utilize the spaces. We have been asking either to install some coin-operated machines for the patients to utilize. Because every day, it's a struggle to run a business in the locality. I have lost quite a lot of patients due to there's no parking issue. Because they come from the neighboring town, Everett, East Boston, or from Winthrop. I lost all those patients because they have no parking. Even one day, a patient was waiting to pick up another patient. The meter maid issued a ticket. That's not reasonable. What his responsibility is, there's a person in the driver's seat, he's waiting to be pick up a patient, but he got a ticket for $50 for standing. So this eliminate my business to utilize the space that was allocated in the past meeting. For 2 hours doesn't mean a thing to me at this point, because also in the board it says 2-hour parking limit and residential permit, that all the residents with the permit were taken out of the space. So I have no space whatsoever unless the council grant coin-operated machines for those 6 spots, or give us a visitor's parking, like Cambridge. My in-law is a commissioner of zoning. They all issue visitor parking, 2-hour limit. So they put it on the vehicle, go and do the service, come back, and we can recycle until 9, until 6 p.m. We are not going to use the space after that. If that can be arranged, that would be great help.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, we've talked a few times about this. I'm Fidel, right? And we've had a few conversations about the spots. The issue that we have, sir,
yes,
is that we have residents who come, you know, and they complain to us about not having parking.
Yeah.
Right? And the reason why those parking spots are that way is because we received a lot of concerns from people who were saying that people outside of Chelsea would come and they would park there and take the Silver Line into Boston, right? So this was a request that came to us, you know, to try to help the residents. I'm not giving you an answer.
Yeah.
I'm just explaining to you why it was done, right? We had a process for those spots, right? I mean, and it's not the only place where it happens. We just have to always juggle, you know, the demands from everyone, right? And I just wanted to explain to you that the reason why those spots are that way is because we were getting complaints of residents who were saying that people would come and they would park there all day, right? And they would take the train into Boston.
Well, this is why, instead of eliminating that situation, if you give us 6 working passes, like day passes, like 9 until 6 p.m., put it on the windshield of the patient's car. After they use 9 to 6, if there's any car with that passes, you can tow them. We will recycle those 6 spots, because now we have no spots whatsoever.
I understand. It's complicated.
Yeah. So first, I appreciate you putting forward this request to us, and we do empathize with the position that you're in as a small business owner attempting
yes.
to conduct business
yes.
and locate adequate parking for your clientele. Echoing what the commissioner said, you know, this is something that we have to balance. Parking demand in that neighborhood is exceptionally high due to the nearby train station and Silver Line station. I think on the idea relative to the parking passes, I don't believe, and Rosa can interject here if I'm wrong, but I don't believe we have a mechanism to do that, meaning there's no law that would allow us to create that new type of pass for you. We don't have a visitor pass of that type.
No, because you would have to make amendments. And then if we were to give a visitor pass, it's not going to help the situation, because residents are still going to park there that live there. If there's a 2-hour limit with the exception of residents permit right now. So
right.
Are you saying that just give visitor passes so they could still park there without a visitor pass? Your complaint is because there's residents parking there, so we can't, we would have to, I'm not sure what you're asking. Are you asking to eliminate residents from parking there?
No.
And just your
no.
patients
the last,
with that
last,
pass?
Yeah, last
so the passes aren't going to do, the passes are not going to help your situation, because if they have a visitor pass, with or without a visitor pass, they can park there right now for 2 hours.
No, that spot is not there, because the residents takes
exactly,
over the space.
Exactly. So a visitor pass is not going to, it's not going to make a difference.
No, even if they find a space, because of the sign says 2-hour parking limit with resident permit, then people, all residents takes the space.
Right.
So I still lose it. So unless otherwise, you allocate 6 spots with the meter parking, like in the downtown, then that can eliminate
right.
that problem.
But in the downtown, residents are still entitled to park at those meters.
No, the business owners in the Broadway, I think.
Residents above Broadway can also park at those meters, though. So I think what Rosa is conveying is that there's no way that we can prevent adjacent residents from using those on-street spaces.
So what is the alternative for me to run a business in that locality? I'm losing patients day by day because of the parking issue. This all arises after the Silver Line extension was
mm-hmm.
done. Before that, we have no restriction whatsoever.
So what I would propose is that, if this is okay with you, that we table this request and spend the next 2 to 3 weeks internally discussing and critically analyzing potential solutions.
Yes.
And we can report back to you at the next meeting in October as to whether there are any solutions we're not thinking of right now, But I will be completely honest that this is a tough one. This is a tough one because we have to balance these competing demands.
I had a meeting with the city manager. Then he said, no, nothing can be done because the councils are on vacation until today is the first meeting. After 3 months, all my patients have been getting $50 ticket. I mean, they don't want to come back.
Well, the $50 ticket is because they're parking at the hydrant. There's a hydrant there.
No. Yes. This is, no, ma'am. This is
a $50 ticket would be the hydrant.
Madam, this patient was waiting, a driver was waiting for to pick up a patient.
At the hydrant?
It's at the entrance to my office. And he was given a $50 ticket and she's appealing. The Ardelia Santisio. Her boyfriend came to pick her up.
Yeah, it was at the hydrant. I saw it. Yes, she was parked at the hydrant.
But the patient, the driver is there. He didn't leave the place. If he's moved, then you can issue the ticket. The driver is there.
You can't just park any at a hydrant, even if to wait for somebody. Unfortunately, they have to find a legal parking space.
I need a solution, sir. If I want to run a business at that locality, I need a solution. This is not the way I can run the office because I'm losing patients unless I move the office to somewhere else.
We understand. So we'll spend the next few weeks attempting to identify a solution and see if we can work with you on one. And you know, in the meantime, we're happy to meet with you or to delve into the details about the types of tickets that are being issued, because it sounds as if there are two-hour parking zones available. They're just not, they're occupied when your patients are attempting to seek them. So I would make a motion to table this until the upcoming meeting, pending further investigation.
I need a solution. That's why I requested this hearing, because it's an ongoing battle. Nobody realized, but I'm facing day to day because of the patients.
We understand. And you know, if we can find a solution, we're willing to work with you on that solution. So just bear with us. You know, we'll be able to report back at our next meeting.
So I had to wait until next hearing to get an answer?
Correct. Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. All right, to move on, we're going to be going to item number 6, communication of May 19, 2021 from Paul Nowicki of the Chelsea Housing Authority requesting a discussion of traffic concerns at the intersection of Lock Street and Webster Avenue.
So I make a motion to close this item. We actually worked with Paul and his team quite a bit. We did two-speed radar signs on Webster as you approach Lock Street. We also did a box in the intersection as well, that was hopefully going to making a left turn out of Lock Street easier. And so far, I've heard from Paul that these small changes have made a difference. So I make a motion to close.
Second.
All right, moving on to item number 8, the public hearing to receive comment on the request to eliminate one parking spot along 2nd Street between Broadway and Winter-Simmons Street due to the refurbishment project of the Chelsea Square and 2nd Street.
So this item is related to a forthcoming project that the city will undertake this fall. It's funded by the Community Development Block Grant Program. The project seeks to upgrade sidewalks, wheelchair ramps, lighting, and trees along the segment of 2nd Street between Broadway and Winter-Simmons Street. As part of this initiative, the proposed project will elevate that stub of 2nd Street to better connect the two portions of Chelsea Square, making it more conducive for events and a bit more comfortable to gather in. So because we're elevating the roadway, we will have to then sort of descend back down to Winter-Simmons Street in order to properly meet grades. And as a result of that descent, one parking space would be lost as part of this project. We did explore, you know, whether there are other suitable locations to add an additional parking space. Because of the configuration of Chelsea Square and the numerous crosswalks around it, we weren't able to find a location. So we are requesting approval to eliminate this one parking space to accommodate this project.
Is anybody here from the public to speak on this?
Okay.
Wait, you got to make a motion?
Yeah, so just something quickly. This little area is being used more and more for public events. I'm sure you all saw the Apollinaire Theater had a beer garden there. I mean, it's really starting to draw residents and draw businesses, you know, to the Chelsea Square area. And we really feel that by raising the roadway, it's going to make it more, you know, more friendly environment. It's going to be safer, and it's going to make it easier to have safe events in the future. So I make a motion to approve by saying that the benefits outweigh the cost here in this little stretch.
Can I just ask how are you going to raise the streets?
It's going to be level. So
level,
basically,
with the sidewalk?
Exactly. So there'll be a little bump, you know,
yeah,
what I mean, as you approach the street.
Yeah.
And a bump back. So, you know, maybe 6 inches.
All right.
I would assume.
All right. Now I'm just thinking of our apparatus.
Of course.
Yeah.
It's a gradual grade too,
yeah,
so that's why we have to take out one of these parking spaces, just so we can incrementally kind of ramp up.
Good.
I'll second that motion.
All approve? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Carolyn?
All right, moving on to item number 9, the handicapped sign application of December 4th, 2020, from Santos Miranda at 75 Congress Ave.
On this one, remember it came to us like 6 months ago, and she was going in for surgery and that, so we approved it for 6 months, and then told her it was like a temporary, and then she would have to come back to see if she still needed the handicap.
Okay.
So.
Yo le traduzco, ¿está bien? Si quieres.
¿Qué quiere que diga?
No, pues lo que dijo Rosa es que se le aprobó por 6 meses,
uh-huh,
¿verdad? Entonces queremos que hoy pues nos diga si todavía lo necesita.
Sí, todavía lo necesito porque no puedo caminar mucho y me cuesta caminar y sí lo necesito y les agradezco mucho que me hayan ayudado con eso.
So she says that she still needs it, that it's hard for her to walk still, and that she thanks us for helping her. I do see that the placard is now has been extended until 2022, right? So I'm going to ask her if this is a permanent request at this point, or if it's a temporary one. Okay.
Yeah.
Está pidiendo que sea permanente o que sea solo por 6 meses otra vez.
Yo pienso que va a ser permanente porque de la cirugía que me hicieron, pues he quedado muy dañada y por ahorita y necesito otra cirugía más y pues no sé cuánto tiempo más.
She's saying that she would like it to be permanent. That after the initial surgery, she's really really struggling, and she has another surgery that is scheduled.
Yo les he preguntado a los doctores por ahorita y ellos dicen que no, que ellos no saben ya trabajar, dicen ellos que ya no voy a poder trabajar.
So she's asked her doctors for a timeline for her to return back to work, and they're telling her that she probably will not be able to return back to work.
Okay.
I'm currently just still just that one and the one at 89 and 118.
You know, given the circumstances and the long recuperation period faced by the applicant, I would recommend approving this request and making this sign permanent.
Okay.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay. Se lo aprobamos, señora.
Okay, muchísimas gracias.
Muchísimas gracias. Buenas noches.
Yeah,
sí, ya. Yeah. Gracias.
Okay, moving on to item number 10, a handicap sign application of June 17, 2021 from Stephen Valderas Alvarez at 142 Chestnut Street.
Yo le traduzco, está bien. Sí.
Buenas tardes, mi nombre es Maura Álvarez, mamá.
¿Se puede acercar un poquito más?
Mi nombre es Maura Álvarez, les doy.
¿Puede firmar el papel, poner su nombre en el papel?
Tiene su nombre en el papel. Y su dirección
she's
también.
The mom.
She's the mother.
Yeah.
Okay. Y la dirección también. Sí, también. Por favor, gracias.
Okay. Sí, yo soy la mamá de Steven. Él pues tiene condiciones de síndrome de Down.
So I am Steven's mother, and he has Down syndrome.
23 de agosto fue operado de corazón abierto.
He had an open heart surgery on the 23rd of August.
Y entonces pues yo siempre la calle en que donde yo vivo pues es una calle bien congestionada de parque.
And on the street that I live in there's not a lot of parking.
Y a veces me toca pues ir hasta allá a la 80 de la Everett, por allá a veces a parquearme, entonces en las condiciones del niño, a veces cuando está la nevada, vengo a veces con esa nevada así, y pues mi condición también, a veces pues por tal vez por no aflojarlo a él, pues me... Yo
and she has to walk a long way, sometimes even to Everett Avenue, to find a parking spot, and that given his condition, and her condition as well, she would like to make a request.
Entonces, por esa la razón la cual yo pues estoy solicitando de que si me pueden apoyar en darme ese parking ahí al frente de mi casa.
And this is the reason why she is requesting a handicap spot in front of her house.
Do you have a list of the ones nearby?
Currently we have 172, 122, 135, and so it's 122, 135, 172, and 258.
Y la que los otros parqueos le queda muy largo.
Quedan un poquito retirados, pero las personas no son siempre son estables ahí. No, nunca he hallado ese parqueo pues vacío.
That those neighboring spots are a little far, but they're really heavily used. That they are not vacant typically.
Any commissioners have any questions on this application? Right, I'd make a motion to accept the request as presented.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, señora. Se lo vamos a instalar. Okay. Muchas gracias. Buenas noches.
Okay, moving on to item number 11. Handicap sign application on June 25th, 2021, from Rafael Menjavia of 8 Reynolds Ave.
Can you please sign the form?
I can wait for the,
Pero me puedes escribir su nombre en el, en el, en la hoja? Sí, su nombre, por favor.
Sí. I would like to be Spanish.
Sí, sí, hable. Le traduzco, si quiere.
No es good.
No, que ¿quiere hablar español?
Sí,
sí, está bien. Y le traduzco yo.
Ok, ¿la pregunta o...?
No, pues, es para que nos, nos explique, pues, la, ¿por qué lo necesita?
Oh, no, he solicitado la... El handicap de ella porque pues recibí un trasplante de hígado y desde esa, antes del trasplante me dio una enfermedad que se llama nervio, es dado a la cortada. Esa una vez también me caí del segundo piso, me quebré aquí, aquí, aquí.
So he,
en segunda, y
he's requesting a handicap spot because he just had a liver transfer and he also had an injury that really affected his legs.
Y me dio el coronavirus ahí en marzo del año pasado y eso me quedó pues que si el, los manos y los pies se me duermen en la caminada, pues ese es el gran problema que tengo.
And he also got the coronavirus in March of last year, and it really affected his joints. And walking long distances is really hard.
I'm on Reynolds currently. Let's see. There's one at 4 and one at 34.
Hay un handicap en el 4 de la Reynolds.
Sí, la 8.
¿Puede usar eso o no lo puede usar?
No.
Que hay un handicap spot en la 4 de la Reynolds.
Hay uno de allí, pero siempre está ocupado y yo pues toco una cuadra porque eso calle está full.
Okay.
Entonces ir a caminar y hoy en el invierno, oh my God, es un gran problema. Y puedo caminar una cuadra, más de una cuadra.
So he's saying that the one around his house is always used, it's heavily used, and the next one closest is over one block away, and it's really hard to walk in the winter in particular.
Mi problema solo es que la caminada es.
Yeah, and he has a hard time with walking.
Make a motion to approve this request.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Se la aprobamos, señor.
Okay. Muchísimas gracias.
Sí, gracias. Toma como un mes el proceso, pero Rosa le va a decir cuándo ya. The gentleman up there, you want to call out of order?
No, just if it just.
So moving on to item number 12 is communication of August 3rd, 2021 from Fidel Maltese The Department of Public Works requesting the removal of the no parking during school hours signs on Broadway at St. Rose.
So this is, it is really administrative in nature. The with the closing of St. Rose School, we no longer need, you know, any signs that restrict during school hours. However, we brought it in front of the commission because it was originally approved by the commission. So I make a motion to approve this item.
Second that motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right, moving on to item number 13, handicap sign application for August 5th, 2021 from Daimera Lewis Jean of 824 Broadway.
Signs up in this section of Broadway, Rosa?
On Broadway right now, we have one at 725, one at 850, and one at 855.
So the application looks complete. Do any commissioners have any questions on this one? All right, I'd make a motion to approve it.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right, moving on to item number 14, which is communication on August 10th, 2021 from Fidel Maltese of the Department of Public Works requesting to modify the traffic signal in intersection markings of Spruce Street and Everett Avenue.
So this we hired our traffic engineering engineering firm to look at the intersection of Spruce and Everett. What we are seeing is that a lot of vehicles are on the left-hand side, right? And they want to make a left from Spruce onto Everett. And because it's not a dedicated lane or light, they're always creeping, right? Into the intersection. So what this proposal is going to make is basically make a dedicated left turn lane on Spruce to make a left into Everett. We will modify the road for it with proper markings, proper signage, and we're going to modify the street light as well so that the vehicles that are on the left-hand side will have a dedicated left turn onto Everett.
So as folks know, the approaches on Spruce and Everett right now consist of two-lane and three-lane approaches. So this will have not much noticeable difference in terms of traffic flow. When our engineers analyzed the proposed change, they demonstrated that it wouldn't have an effect on the level of service of the intersection. It will improve safety. One of the major safety deficiencies of this intersection are, as cars are creeping, as the commissioner mentioned, they're rear-ending each other and there are many side swipe accidents. So our goal with this is to decrease the number of those types of crashes while streamlining traffic flow. So we are fully in support of this request.
So I make a motion to approve.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, item number 15 is a handicap sign application of August 11th, 2021 from Eric Jovial of 139 Bloomingdale Street.
This is also for a child. The parents were notified, but I don't think anybody's here for it today. The application states the child's in a wheelchair. Bloomingdale, we currently have one at 46, 59, and 68.
Nothing this far up.
I'll make a motion to approve.
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right, moving on to item number 16 is communication of August 16th, 2021 from Edward Mendros of Walnut Street Synagogue requesting parking relief on high holidays at the synagogue from September 6th to the 16th, 2021.
He always brings this in every year for that's around their high holidays times. So, because it's daytime enforced there and they have a lot of people coming into the synagogue for prayer services and that. So they're just looking for like parking relief during the daytime so that their members can park and attend services there.
And in past years, have you had any issue enforcing this? I think it's similar to what has
Yes, we always, like I said, he comes every year. He becomes, it's just a formality that we bring it to the commission. But he does, he comes every year around the same time.
I would make a motion to approve the request. I'll just add that the city, through negotiations with Mass Department of Transportation, recently opened about 170 parking spaces underneath Route 1 adjacent to Everett Ave, between Everett Ave and Williams Street. So those spaces are open to public parking during the day. There is a modest fee, and then they're open overnight to residents. So that might also be a parking option here in addition to the
I'll,
street
I'll,
spaces.
I'll let them know on that.
Thank you.
Second, anybody second?
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right, moving on to item number 17. Communication of September 1st, 2021 from Ben Kears, Department of Housing and Community Development, requesting to institute pedestrian safety measures, bus stop improvements, and bike lanes on Hawthorne Street adjacent from the Early Learning Center.
So presently we're advancing the design of pedestrian safety countermeasures along Hawthorne Street at the intersection of Central Ave, Hawthorne, and Park Street. This school walking route encompasses a high crash cluster with numerous crashes occurring over the last 5 years. So we've hired our on-call transportation company, TEC, to prepare a plan of interim safety measures that could be implemented with low-cost treatments. So this is the plan that they've proposed. The illustrative plan shows painted curb extensions, new crosswalks, signage, and bicycle facilities. The one revision I would put forward for this plan is that we're still exploring whether bike lanes can be feasible on the stretch of Hawthorne Street. So for the time being, we're proposing shared lane markings on Hawthorne Street for bicycles and vehicles to share the road. Upon the commission and council's approval, our plan would be to implement the configuration that's illustrated before you early this fall with a construction completion date before the end of December.
And just to add on what Alex said, this is in line again with all of the safety improvements that we're doing around the ELC, and we're really trying to increase pedestrian safety and bicyclist safety as well. And this project is a good complement, you know, into the corridor that we are building in the downtown. So I would make a motion to approve.
I would second, although it'd be nice if we could keep the bike line.
So we're approving excluding the bike lane?
So right now we're still exploring it with our other engineering firm for Broadway. So we're looking at whether we can do a full bike lane or if it has to be a shared lane marking. I think we're leaning more towards the shared lane marking because of some engineering issues with the road, but we haven't made the final determination.
So what would be the motion?
So you could approve it with the bike lane if that is the goal of the commission, and then we could see if we could accommodate it, or you could approve it with just the shared lane and we could go that route. It's completely up to the commission. That's
it could be wide enough to, you have to lose parking, I think, along the school, I think, right?
So that's what we're concerned about, particularly near Bellingham Square with the bus stop.
Yeah.
Whether it's wide enough to accommodate a bike lane, regular vehicular lanes, and then the bus stop.
Right.
Yeah, so
issues.
The alternative is the green boxes, right?
Yeah.
That just have like a bicycle on top, and it's supposed to tell motorists, you know, to be mindful of bikes.
Yeah.
Basically, it's not a bike lane.
So Fidel, your motion is to approve it?
So I would motion to approve it with the shared lane, not the dedicated bike lane.
With the shared lane?
With the shared lane.
Anybody second it?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, moving on to item 18 is handicap sign removal at 265 Maple Street as the applicant has moved.
Make a motion to approve the request.
Second the motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right. Item 19 is handicap sign removal at 46 Ormond Street as the applicant has moved.
Make a motion to approve the request.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Okay, then we make item number 20 would be a handicap sign removal at 26 Blossom Street as the applicant has moved.
Make a motion to approve the request.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I should say, I don't mean to go back or anything, but we just did a handicap sign removal at 46 Orange Street.
But this is it.
But earlier on,
yeah,
we just approved one for 46.
So
it's
swap.
We're not actually moving it, we're just swapping it out.
Yes, so this is the same.
Okay. I just didn't know if you were, if we were going to be back here with another applicant. Another
yeah, no, that was, it's for the same one. We just approved before we removed.
All right. Sorry about that.
All right. Now, item number 21 is handicap sign removal at 5 John Street as the applicant no longer qualifies for the program.
A motion to approve the request.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Item number 22 is handicap sign removal at 57 Addison Street per applicant no longer needed.
Make a motion to approve the request.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Item number 23 is handicap sign removal at 38 Hancock Street as the applicant has passed away.
Make a motion to approve the request.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right. Item number 24 is handicap sign removal at 131 Walnut Street as the applicant has passed away.
Make a motion to approve the request.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Item number 25 is handicap sign removal at 160 Spencer Avenue as the applicant has passed away.
Make a motion to approve the request.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Item number 26 is handicap sign removal at 143 Orange Street as the applicant has passed away.
Make a motion to approve the request.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, we're moving on to item 27 is handicap sign removal at 74 Garland Street as the applicant has passed away.
Make Make a motion to approve the request.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Item 28 is handicap sign removal at 7 Clinton Street as the applicant is non-responsive to renewal request.
Make a motion to approve the request.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Item number 29 is handicap sign removal at 73 Maverick Street as the applicant has passed away.
Make a motion to approve the request.
I'll second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Right, item 30 is a communication of September 2nd, 2021 from Lisa Sanigate at 221 Shirtless Street, requesting that the commission to find a different solution than to restrict the disabled from being able to park in the handicapped spaces at 569 Broadway on the first and third Friday of each month from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. during the street sweeping season.
So I make a motion to table this item until the next event. Actually, Ms. Sanigate wasn't available to attend the meeting, and we did have a few different options. Like the issue is that these are the only two handicap spots for the library, right? I mean, and when we sweep on Broadway, those handicap spots are not available. So one solution would be to add one spot on Marlboro Street, maybe, right? That gives people, you know, some alternatives, or to add one on Library Street. It would be another alternative. So I would like to have an opportunity to just confer with Ms. Sanigate as to what she believes is the best option. So I make a motion to table the item until our next month.
All right, I'll second that motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Are you here for some?
The fireman,
right?
The fireman?
Retired.
Yes.
Yeah.
You're right at the beginning?
Like I said at the beginning, we're not able to speak on that today because it wasn't presented to us and it wasn't put on our agenda for us to look into it, you know.
I just came back from vacation today. There was a fire on my door.
Yeah.
It was a local councilwoman.
Yeah. Yeah, unfortunately, we weren't advised of it ahead of time to put it on our agenda, so we'd have to reach out to your counselor to see what, you know, what her, if she wants to bring it to us for our next agenda, which would be in October.
Okay, we're gonna call this meeting adjourned.
Thank you.
Thank you.